To win a war, you need the right stuff. Clothes, food, and weapons. Those are the essentials. So how well equipped was the British soldier in 1914? British forces had lots of different uniforms and equipment, but the most iconic uniform of all was worn by the British infantrymen on the trenches of the Western Front. So there it is, the British infantrymen ready for action. But just how ready? The British infantrymen went into World War I as the best prepared soldier on the planet. Let's take this for example, the Lee Enfield rifle. The Brits were famously fast and accurate using this rifle. It could take 10 rounds in the magazine. The British built 4 million of these during the war. They're in service for years after. This was the best rifle on the Western Front. Now, instead of gaiters, the British had the ingenious idea of puttees that they brought over from their experience in India. They'd wrap these right around the lower leg, and that would keep your legs dry and also provide a lot of support as well. One of the biggest challenges for any soldier in the past or the present is carrying the sheer amount of kit they need to keep themselves alive and take the fight to the enemy. Now, the British soldiers, the 1908 pattern webbing just slipped over the body like this, and it allowed them to carry much of what they needed into battle. A water bottle here, ammunition here and here, and my bayonet, 17 inches of sharpened steel, right here. Hidden around the back, the entrenching tool, or spades, you and me. Simply drop that in there. This allowed British soldiers to get themselves out of trouble if they're being shot at by immediately digging a mini hole in the ground and getting themselves out of harm's way. Now, the British kit was good. It wasn't perfect. Now, this is a cloth cap, it's a good bit of camouflage, but obviously it provided no protection against high-velocity shrapnel, and that's why about halfway through the war, steel helmets were issued to all the British troops. But believe it or not, this was still a lot better than what the French and Germans had, the German pickle horn. It's made of leather, and it provided an obvious target for marksmen. And if Britain had the best prepared soldiers, no prizes for guessing who wasn't too far behind. But if the German kit wasn't as up-to-date as the British, they did have one major advantage. There were over 4 million of them. At least German battle dress was fit for fighting in a 20th century war. In 1914, one army's soldiers were colour-coordinated more for the Parisian runways than the trenches. Ooh la la. It's not that the French military hadn't heard of khaki, but lots of countries were unprepared in 1914 and couldn't produce tons of new kit overnight. Sometimes you gotta make do with what you've got. The British Army's bang up-to-date uniform and weaponry was down to its battle-hardened experience, just as well, because they would need every advantage they could get. And what about that other essential of military life, food? The High Command knew that without good food, no battles would be won at all. And that's why the Brits were actually provided with a pretty generous diet. Bacon here, some corned beef, a quarter of a loaf of bread, cheese, load of vegetables, some mustard, and last but not least, each day the men were issued with two big tablespoons full of rum. This is the wash kit roll here. They wouldn't have tended to use the knife and fork when they're up in the front line. They just used the spoon to shovel everything in. But they would have used the razor. They had to shave every single day, no matter what, except their top lips. Soldiers in World War I had to wear a moustache, if they could grow one.
But back to food. At the start of the war, how did enemy rations compare? Bring on the heavy artillery, meat and potatoes. In 1914, Brits enjoyed more meat than the Germans. We're not talking juicy steaks exactly, but you could make a nice hearty stew. Better than some of the soldiers have been used to back home. But over the course of the war, more and more meat was of the tin variety. Too much could lead to indigestion, diarrhea, and vomiting. Nice. In the Battle of the Carbs, the Germans were the clear winners. Although at least the British soldier had something to put on his bread. But as the war continued, resources became scarce, and in Germany especially, there was a crippling shortage of food. For the soldiers, the daily ration dwindled, until by 1918, all a German soldier might eat was turnip stew, served with turnip bread. Each side had an arsenal of condiments, but probably of more interest to the soldier in his trench was exactly how much alcohol he could look forward to each day. Germans were given generous rations of alcohol and tobacco to enjoy, easily more than the British soldier. But at least he had some cheese. Party on. So who wins? At the start of the war, in terms of calories, the British soldier is the clear victor, with almost 1,000 more than his enemy. But given that generous booze allowance, perhaps the German soldier wasn't too bothered.
The British generals knew that food, just like proper boots, uniforms, and rifles, was absolutely vital if they wanted to win World War I. And the reason they knew that was because Britain had been involved in a lot of fighting over the previous generation, particularly during the Boer War in South Africa. They'd learned from their mistakes so that by 1914, food and their equipment was fit for purpose. I get another one, right, Sarge?